Good evening. The new Labor cabinet has been unveiled with the team sworn in today at Government House. Caroline O'Day joins us live now. Caroline, it's a mixed bag.
Well, Jen, after the Labor landslide, the highly anticipated lineup can be revealed. After being in opposition for just one term, there are plenty of new faces, plenty of old faces, and some surprises in there. There are also some women in the mix, but not as many as some would have liked to see, and they have fallen short of that 50-50 gender split that we did see whilst in opposition.
A new look for Labor, with the Malinowskis cabinet stepping up after being sworn in at Government House.
And what you'll see is that it's very diverse. It is progressive and it is modern.
Chris Picton is the new health minister. Tom Koutsantonis has landed transport and infrastructure, and Blair Boyer education. While former federal MP Nick Champion's move to state politics comes with responsibilities for urban development and planning. Of the 15 in cabinet, just six are women. While Labor achieved a 50-50 gender split on the front bench in opposition, a number of highly regarded women were today overlooked.
All of those women, I can guarantee, at some point will be on the front bench. They are all intelligent, charismatic, and committed to their communities.
The surprise appointment sparked an outpouring of emotion. Independent MP Jeff Brock handed local government and veteran affairs during a call from Peter Malinowskis on Tuesday.
I'm very, very fearful about my independence. I rang the Premier back, I said, well, one of the things I do want to do is that if I accept this position, that I am not a Labor minister.
Other members of the new cabinet had to tune in remotely due to COVID rules.
The four ministers who missed today's event will be here in the coming days for their own official ceremony,
including new Attorney General Khayyam Maher, who also returns to the Indigenous Affairs portfolio. Caroline O'Day for 10 News First.